Hello, everybody. This is Neanderthal MC, and welcome back. What is that? Oh, it's gone. Okay. And this is our. Oh, there, it's back again. It's not raining. And then it comes back again. Well, anyways, this is Neanderthal MC, and welcome back to our Sky Factory. Today, I will be going through lots of stuff that I've done off-camera again, like I always do. But once again, I lied to you last episode. I have not done two of the things that I said I was going to do. But I have worked on a lot of stuff that is going to help us progress very, very much faster than we have been before. So, what I'm standing on is a sprinkler, by the way. It's just sprinkling. That's what you're seeing. And as you can see, there's a new thing we have. We might as well go through that first. What we have here is a sprinkler from OpenBlocks, and all that is I think it's just a redstone torch, some iron on the sides, and then iron fences on the top and bottom, and that gives you a sprinkler. And what you do is you put that over top an aqueous accumulator, and you don't have to run water to this guy because, or you don't have to put water sources around it because it sucks in enough water from the atmosphere, I guess you could call it, by itself to run the sprinkler. So you don't have to hook up anything. You just have to put this guy below the sprinkler, and the sprinkler will run forever. And what the sprinkler does is it waters a 9x9 area, so what we have here. So it waters what a regular water source would, but it speeds up the growing process. Also, you could put bone meal in here to make it grow even faster, but I don't have anything automated for that so far. So this is what we have right now. And then as you can see, we have some magical crops growing. I've been thinking of ways to get redstone and Certus Quartz because that is what we really need to do these computer parts. These guys right here, these storage units, which we desperately, desperately, desperately need to help solve our storage problem right now. And so the only way to get those is to have tons of iron, which we have from our sifting situation, tons of Certus Quartz, which we get a little bit from our sifting, and redstone, tons of redstone, which we get a little bit from our sifting. So what I wanted to do was I basically went in here and I went quartz, it's with a Z, and so recipe. The only way to get it is to freeze nether quartz, which is even harder to get than Certus Quartz. So we're not going to do that. We don't have these blocks. And we don't have this ore. But there is a way to get the ore. Sorry about that. There is a way to get the ore. And so 8 Certus Quartz essence gives you 4 ore. And then 4 ore gets you 8 quartz. And a 10% chance of a dust, which we don't really need because we get tons of that too. So basically every single dust or every single essence turns into 1 Certus Quartz. And so that's pretty darn good. And so the only way to get, but the way to get, let's just start over again. Quartz, to get the quartz, you need the, or you could sift sand, but that takes too long. So you need quartz ore, and the only way to get quartz essence is to get, a quartz seed, a magic, or what is it called? I have them right here. A Certus Quartz crop. And the only way to get that is to start off with getting an essence seed. And the only way to get an essence seed is to bone meal grass and get really lucky. And I didn't even try to get this essence seed. I was just bone mealing grass. I lost my achievement book, and I was trying to get purple dye, which you need to make another one. And so I was trying to get red flowers, and I accidentally got an essence crop, and that got me thinking. And so what you do is you take, I think I have some in here. Yeah, I got lots in here. So, yes. So you take, so the first step is to take an essence seed, which you get from breaking grass, and then you put that in a crafting, oh wait, yeah. No, you plant this. You plant this in the ground, and you'll get this essence dust out of it. So you get when it grows, and it does take a long time to grow, and you can't use bone meal, but you can use a watering can, which I'll get to in a little bit. You plant the seed. It grows up like these guys are, And then you break it and you get this essence dust. And what you do with this essence dust is you put it around a weak infusion stone. And the only way to get that is to put more essence dust around a diamond or an emerald. And so that wasn't too hard. So use that. Got some weak essence dust. And then you use that around seeds and then whatever type of thing you want to make. So if I want to make coal seeds, I do 4 weak essence, some regular seeds, and then coal, and I get 1 coal seed, or 1 dye seed, or 1 water seed. I don't know what water gives you. Oh well, we haven't done that. I did do dye, and I have also, yeah, just dye. I haven't done this. Air seeds. I haven't tried that. Anyways, but I have done the dye seeds because I wanted a better source for, like, insects. You can get insects out of this dye essence that you get from the dye seeds. But then what you also get So weak essence, and then you can use the weak essence around a regular infusion stone, which is, again, some of the essence, the next level essence, so the second tier essence around the weak infusion stone. You get the weak infusion stone back, and you also get the regular infusion stone. And so this can be used... to get this regular essence, and then you can use the regular essence and a seed to get redstone seed, which I made, as well as, oh, that's it, yeah, and then you can use the regular essence around a strong infusion stone, which I made by surrounding it with redstone essence. You get a strong essence, and then that can be used for making iron seeds, gold, blaze, lapis, ender, experience, nether, gunpowder, or I guess your creeper, cow, magma seeds, so I guess magma, magma cube seeds, skeleton, spider, slime, fire resistance, ghast, all types of different potions. Some of the more rare metals, like silver, lead, what's that, tin, oh, aluminum, and most importantly, Certus quartz. And so what I have right now is I have an abundant supply of essence seeds, dye seeds, redstone seeds, and Certus quartz seeds. And so I've just been, I started a little automatic thing here. I also have a staircase because I was sick of running all the way to over there and then down. So yeah, just made a little crappy staircase here. And so what I have going on here is I have a planter underneath here. Right above the planter, I have the aqueous accumulator and the sprinkler. So the planter plants the seeds in this 9x9 area because I gave it a tin upgrade, so it will only plant in this area. And then I have a harvester over here, which is getting powered by a lava generator, which is from this little thing right here. I didn't really need an ender generator over that because it doesn't require that much power. So we got the lava generator powering the planter and the harvester, and then I have the sludge going all over the sludge boiler, and then I have the items going in here. For right now, this is just a temporary setup. So I have the items going in here, all the seeds, all the things that it harvests, so the seeds and the essence will go into here, and then the seeds are being brought out the bottom of that chest and back into the planter. But the only thing I have that's going wrong right now is this harvester for the trees is actually harvesting this little corner of the crops too. And so every once in a while I'll have some crops in here. Oh, and then I have this field over here too. Oh boy. Yeah, I haven't harvested in a while. So yeah, if I break these are essence crops. You get weak essence is a very rare drop, as well as nature essence. And nature essence can be used to make moss stone, mossy bricks, vines, lily pads, mycelium, and then this magic fertilizer, as well as magical food, which gives you health regen 3, which is pretty amazing. So yeah, and then you get weak essence as a drop, but every single time you get a seed, well, most of the time you get one seed, and then it's a little bit more rare to get two, and then it's really rare to get none, and so you usually get one for one, and I found that you get two more than you get zero, so your supply does grow quite quickly. Yeah, these guys aren't set up with harvesters or planters. These are just manual fields. And so how the dye essence works is you press U, and you can see that If you put three in the top, you get ink sacs. If you do three in the bottom, you get cactus green. Three in the middle, you get red. And all these different formations give you the different kinds of dye. And what's nice is it doesn't give you black dye. It gives you ink sacs, which can be used for more than just dyeing stuff black. You can use them for a printer, or I guess all this is dyeing stuff black, isn't it? Glasses. Reading glasses. Oh, you can use them for creepy dolls. A clipboard. Yeah, so that's kind of cool. You can make music discs. Oh, a stall too. I might think about doing that. Huh, that's my favorite record, by the way, if I haven't told you. So yeah, it's nice. You could also farm lapis using that, but we have a pretty good supply of lapis from our sifting going on downstairs. So, lots of farming going on. I haven't been farming food just because we don't really need any yet. We got tons of stockpiled food like potatoes and carrots and all kinds of apples too from our trees. So basically what I've done is I've been doing a lot of automating. And so I've been just leaving my computer on. I've been coming back and it's got, you know, just stacks on stacks of redstone and quartz. And so I've been finally able to speed up my production of those storage units, and I have actually farmed enough of these crops to get enough quartz, redstone, and then I've waited long enough for the iron and the glass and diamonds and gold and things like that needed to make all of the parts I need to make. I think it's I'm not sure. I need to go look how big this thing is that we're about to make. Because I have it all queued up. All right, so I'll just show you what I have going on here. You must have noticed the big stack of crafting benches over here. And so what I have is I have the recipe for the basic storage cell. I need to look it up. Storage. Where are they? This one. Storage cell, yeah. So this recipe makes storage cells. This, you put the storage cells in, and you get the next biggest storage cell, which is the storage segment, and then you put those three in, and then you get a storage block, and then you put those three in, and you get a storage cluster, and then you put those three in, and as you can see, this one takes quartz, redstone, and ME basic processors, and the ME basic processors take gold, silicon, redstone, and a quartz cutting knife. So this is a lot of steps. And so I've been doing that up here. And then, so I've made lots of redstone, gold, and quartz dust, which makes a silicon, go into that. And then, of course, quartz for the cutting knives have gone into that. So you make tons of those. And then in here, it's just more glass and redstone and more basic processors. And then in here, it's glowstone, glass, and advanced processors, which are smelted with, so it's the same as the basic processor, but it's with a diamond instead. So tons of those, and then more advanced processors, more glowstone, more glass, and then the storage block. And then in here, you have the flux dust, which is the pulverized nether quartz, surface quartz, and redstone. So more redstone and more quartz. And then you get the flux dust, and then you get the flux dust with more advanced processors, and then another diamond, and you get these kilo storage clusters. And then I have made three kilo storage clusters, and I'm going to make a mega storage cluster. Boom. Okay, and so what this is used for is I need two quartz glass, and I've already made some of that, and that's pretty easy. It's just some quartz dust. I actually only need two. And so this is made just some surface quartz dust and some glass, so not that big of a deal. Let's just do it up here. So it was those two guys, and then diamonds and more flux dust. So let's get some more diamonds. So you can see I have plenty of diamonds. I have the, what is it? How does this go? I already forgot. Crap. The sifting has been going for a long. Oh yeah, flux dust, that's right. Diamonds on the bottom there, and let's grab some flux dust. Oop. What am I doing? Go back. There we go. So this makes a 1 mil storage, which is like all we have here is 1K, 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 4K, 4K, 16K. This is a million bytes. This is big. So, yeah. This will up our storage by quite a bit. And so it only stores 63 types, so this will be kind of more of like a deep storage stuff. If we want to store more types, all we have to do, if we have lots of different types, but we only have like, you know, 5 mushrooms, 1 mushroom, 6 roses, we'd want to do more 1K storage. But this is for, instead of making deep storage units, this is nicer, because it'll store 63 types of like 100,000 stuff, you know, not 100,000, but 50,000 or so of 63 things. So that's a really nice thing to have, and then I've just been throwing my dye essence in there. So let's just check my stockpile. Yeah, I got quite a bit of nature and dye essence. Let's just turn this redstone essence into redstone, and it is a very high conversion rate. So 8 redstone essence gives you 24. So 1 redstone essence gives you 3 redstone, which is really nice. And I've stockpiled quite a bit of redstone. How much redstone? 760, not counting all the stuff that's in these. We're not counting all of this and all of this. So that's really nice. And then nature essence, put that in there. And then what I do is I get the stones out. All 3 of them. I need all 3 of them. And then I just go to this, let's say, this crafting table. And I get the week. And then you put the essence dust in there like that. Get all the week essence. And then you take that one out. And you put the regular infusion stone in the middle. And then you put that same pattern, you get the regular, and then you put the strong one in, do the same pattern, and then you get the strong essence. And then eventually we'll create more seeds, different kinds. Like eventually we'll probably get, I don't know, cow seeds, so we don't have to farm the cows, and we can just grow leather and things like that. Do I have any, we might as well just make the rest. Oh, never mind, we can't do any more. Okay, that's fine. Let's go grab 2 more, nether or, quartz dust or 10 more. And let's put the strong infusion stone in here and surround it by the Sirtis quartz dust. Oh, that's the same tier as the, okay, never mind. We have to make a different tier of, wait. Strong infusion stone needs to be surrounded by iron. Oh, okay. Never mind, I can't do that yet. That's the same tier as the redstone. All right, so we might as well just do this again. Get that guy out. And then I just have a little pulverizer back here, just for now, just temporary. Then I throw my essence in there. And my stones. And then these, I haven't really been growing the dye seeds. I don't really need them, so I've just been kind of throwing them in here. All right, so all done with that. That was what I've been working on mostly. Quite a bit of time spent in this whole farm situation. I just need to fix. So for next time, the only thing I need to change with this whole farming setup is to probably hook up these 2 farms to automation, as well as decrease the radius. I don't need a diamond upgrade. I just need it to get this area. Actually, I'm gonna move it up, so I'll probably leave it. That was one of the things I said I was gonna do but haven't. Roofs on here and move the tree farm up or off to the side or something. So that will be for next time. What else do I have to show you? I changed how the sifting situation worked down here. I don't think I showed you this. I did end up hooking up the transfer pipe all the way to the iron chest, so this is constantly full. It's always full. If that'll never get to 0, pretty much it'll always fill back up with 64, so that's always full. And so I have 2 outputs going out of here. I have 1 going into the set that will make it into dust, and 1 going into one that'll just turn it into gravel. And so I have gravel going out the bottom of that one into the sifters, and so we're sifting gravel, sifting dust, and then I have, instead of those outputs going back into the chest, I have them going back into the sifter. And so we're having gravel, dust, a little bit of extra dust from this chance, and then a little bit of extra sand, or no, this gives you sand by chance, so a little bit of sand also gets sifted, so we get the, what do we get from sand, like limestone, and I think we get the seeds and things like that. So yeah, we're sifting all three types of, you know, I don't know, we're sifting sand, dust, and gravel, so we're getting all types of that, and so what I had to do is I just had to, put more things, I'd have to put all the different things that would get sifted, since we're doing all three types of material, I'd have to put the pulverized, the crushed, and the broken all into the filters, and so all of the pulverized, crushed, and dust, well, what is it called? Pulverized, crushed, and broken are all going into the smelters. So that's okay. And now we're getting all the drops too, which is really nice. So we're getting diamonds and emeralds and even more redstone, as well as lots of quartz there. Wow, awesome. And so every once in a while, I'll just come out here and I'll empty the chest and I'll run it up and throw it in the computer. So it's working out really well. Got lots of stuff going. What else? As I just go throw this stuff in here, we might as well just take a look at our supplies. Oh, and I just brought a couple stacks of ender pearls up here, put them in a different barrel and have them going in here. So this is always have this always the computer always has power. Yeah, not that big of a change, but it happened. So let's just fill these guys up, because we gotta keep making these. It's gonna be a never-ending thing. I don't think we'll ever have enough room. So let's just do it again. Get some more out. And then I just throw them over here. Put them in here. Get some more. Get some, what are these, clusters? Segments. And then get two more storage blocks. And then, oh, I get to make another cluster. And then the cluster goes there. And then the process keeps going on and on and on, and then I'll probably have to get another drive, stack it on top, no big deal, and then we'll just keep going from there. So let's look at how many diamonds we have. 63 just in the storage. Let's look at how many emeralds, 120 in there. Let's look at our, the foundry over here, I guess I can call it, has been working like crazy. This is just from a few hours. I mean, this thing is literally giving me infinite metal. I just want to show you how much blocks we have of this metal. We could start using iron blocks as building blocks is how much we have. So let's just look at iron. 568 regular iron and 464 blocks just from leaving it on for 2 days. Let's look at shiny metal. 96 blocks and 8 ingots of the shiny metal, which is also platinum. Let's look at copper. 333 blocks plus 573. Let's just look at blocks. That's not an L. Blocks. Oh, no, block. Look at all that. And I've made some alloys, too, just for fun. Oh, and that's all the thaumium we have, too. So look at all that. 248 blocks of gold. And probably a little bit more, probably a little bit extra gold. I've probably turned some in. Yeah, 88 plus that. So tons and tons of metals here. More than we'll ever need. So that's pretty nice to have. So this thing is working like crazy. I didn't drop this stuff off. Let's just do that. All right. Okay, so I remembered the one thing that I did that I haven't showed you yet, and that is a pretty cool device. I'm not sure how much I'm going to use it, but it's just a cool little thing. It's called the Cartographer and the Height Map Projector. I think it's from OpenBlocks, and so here it is. As you can see, that's our skyblock, but in a 3D form, and there's our little there's our mob spawner up there, too, with the snow on it. And so what this guy is, he is called the Height Map Projector, and then what is inside of him is a height map. Oops. Okay, so I took him out on accident. I guess I can't click recipe on him, but what you do is you make a cartographer right there. All that is an ender eye, which is obviously just ender pearl and some blaze powder, if you didn't know. And then you need an assistance base, which is just iron, redstone, and ender pearl. I love open blocks because the recipes are so simple. And then you just combine them together and you get the cartographer. And then I think I have that in my computer, so let's just go grab that. Oh, and then I also set up another row of furnaces just to keep up with the demand here. Anyway, so here he is, cartographer. And he looks like a little ender pearl on a, or ender eye on a stand. And so what you do is you put him down, and there he is. His little eye spins, and he flashes a little number of his coordinate. And when you move, he moves with you. So it's kind of like a little pet. He doesn't really do anything. But when you, what he does do, the only time he does do something is when you give him an empty map. Maple. Oh, okay. I was going to say, why does that come up for map? And that is right here. Oh, and you can scale them too. I didn't notice that. Okay. Empty map is created with, oh no. Where's the first one? Yeah, empty map. Recipe. Oh, here it is. An empty map is created with four memory modules and a map controller module. And these look really complicated. They look like circuit boards, but they're really easy. All it is a redstone and a gold. And then this guy's used, and then you make this, and it's just more gold and a little bit more redstone. And then you just put them in a plus pattern like this, and you get an empty map scale 1-1. And if you want to make it bigger, you put more map memory modules, same thing. You want to make it bigger, 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 all the way to 1-2. Wait. Yeah. How big can you make it? 1-1? 1-8, yeah. How do you make that? Doesn't have a recipe. Oh, well. But anyways, I only made a 1-1 because our place is really tiny here. Obviously, we don't need that big of a map. And so what you do is you shift right click the empty map into him, and then he will go to work. He'll fly around a little bit, and then he'll have a little like I don't know, like maybe a 5x5 little like green box on the side, and that'll slowly fill in, turn a lighter green color. And then when it all turns a lighter green, he's done, and he'll come back and follow you. Then you can shift right click on him again, and he actually, yeah, there we go. He's updating it. So you see that little green box on there lights up. So now he's done. I shift right click on him again, and I get the map back out. And then you go and throw that into this height map projector, and that's right here. And that is simply any kind of slab, redstone, iron, and a glowstone and a lapis. So again, very, very simple, very cheap things that are very cool. I love open blocks for that. And so we could just break him and he'll fly back down to us. And so what you do is you put the height map in here, and it will project it in the air like that. And then you can rotate it. This is the scrolling here doesn't actually change it when you see it on out in the world there, but it just lets you view it in here. So yeah. Here it is. Oh, this needs to be rotated two more times. There we go. Right? What is that? That's the house. Wait. What is this? I'm confused. Okay. It's like this. Right? Yeah. I'm confused. I don't think it got everything. There we go. That's how it's supposed to look. Yeah, it didn't get all the stuff over here for some reason. Okay, but yeah, so I'm working on that. It's a little finicky right now because we don't have very much height. It looks cooler when you have like slopes and hills and stuff. It's not. There's no really point having it 3D if it's only 2D anyways. So that's why I kind of like having this map, which is blank for some reason. Come on, man, it's being really slow, huh? Going on. Okay. I'll do that later. Anyways, I have done a lot with the automation, and that's what I want to start heading towards. Obviously, the mod pack is called Sky Factory, and so that is what we need to be going towards, is a factory type thing where we have less manual labor and more machine labor, obviously. And so for next time, I promise I will do the roofs on the smelteries. I will make a platform for the tree farm, either above me right here, or, you know, off to another square on the checkerboard here. Also, I will continue working on the storage clusters, right? That's what they're called. Whatever, the storage units. Also automating the farm. So, thank you all for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Leave a like below. Also, comment, subscribe, tell your friends about me. I really appreciate it. Again, thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next episode. Bye.